Dozens of local organizations are teaming up to increase state line literacy. United Way of Rock River Valley is leading the charge. Right now, just 1 in 3 children in the area are reading at or above their grade level. This new collaborative effort will use parental engagement, caregiver support, and community awareness to hopefully change that. We have representatives from both the United Way and the library here today. Thank you both so much for being with us.
One in three,
that's a pretty eye-opening statistic. Where does that come from?
It actually comes from the Illinois State Board of Education. So they do a standardized test every year and of the public school children. And the average is based on all of the school districts in Winnebago County. So we average the numbers. So some school districts are less, some are higher. But, and really it's not about the school districts, it's about that number and the fact that they get to third grade and they're not reading at grade level.
So the United Way is taking the lead on this, teaming up with the library. How is the library able to help in this situation?
So library is helping with the education of volunteers. And so anyone who's interested in volunteering for this program, their first step would be to get training from the library. So we're encouraging people to sign up for trainings.
What does that involve as far as like a time commitment?
So training is just about an hour. And then we're looking for no more than an hour per week, I believe is what it is.
Yeah, it depends on, because we're working with, like right now, the Harlem School District. So some adults are going into the classrooms, and so they might be there for an hour a week. We're also looking for story times. We're starting to build up kind of our army, so to speak, of volunteers. So we want to do a lot of things throughout the community. We just launched this September 7th, so we're just getting going.
So once the volunteers are trained, what happens after that?
So yeah, it depends again. Okay. If they go into a school, they might have a couple of kiddos that they work with every hour or once an hour a week. Or if they do a story time, they might do it in their church, in their community center, somewhere else in the community where they're actually helping kids learn how to read and kind of going through the basics. We call them kind of the four core, predicting what the book is going to be about, questioning it, clarifying, and then summarizing. So that's just one of the basic things that the public library will teach them.
Yeah. So for the students who maybe need a little extra help, who identifies them? Their teachers or their parents or either?
Oh boy, that's a really good question. Really what our focus is for those children birth to five, we really want to get them prepared so when they hit those school doors, we know the schools will teach them year after year after year and they'll keep moving them. So we really want to focus maybe on the younger kids. So the parents understanding how to read to your kids and that this is really something you need to do every day. Getting them involved in story times, getting home libraries because a lot of them don't have books at home. So yeah.
Well, from the library's perspective, how important is it to get kids interested in reading and starting that passion for reading at a young age?
I mean, the sooner the better, as soon as possible. I mean, it doesn't even matter if they're an infant. Just hearing reading introduces vocabulary. It allows them to understand tone and emotion and feeling. And there's so many important pre-reading skills that you can do with children who can't even speak yet.
So for parents with babies, it's good to even start reading to them right away, correct?
Absolutely.
And any kind of book will work at that point, right?
Yeah. It really does. And even narrating your day, you know, talk through your day. Just talk about, oh, here I am putting the laundry away. And what are you doing? You're sitting on the floor. You know, whatever it is. And you can read anything to them. The signs. The cereal box, you know.
A menu, when you're making a recipe, speak through, you know, what the steps that you might take.
So, good ideas. So do you have a goal, an end goal for this program, or are you just going to kind of see where it goes?
No, we do. So right now, only 32% of our kids are reading at grade level at third grade. We'd like by the year 2034 that to be 75%, and we just want to keep going. We want this to be a community of readers. Right. We want everybody in Winnebago County to have that opportunity, and we're just doing everything we can. We're partnering with 30-plus organizations to make that happen, and we've set our bold goal. So, but we need everybody to do it, and that's kind of why we wanted to come talk with you and let our viewers know.
Oh, I'm so glad that you did because reading is such a basic skill that you have to have, and it will help the entire community and our workforce if we can have better readers,
especially in such a globalized society too. You know, communication now more than ever is really important.
So. Absolutely. So, if someone would like more information or would like to volunteer, how can they do that?
Yeah, well, we've got wevolunteer.org. Mm-hmm. You can always go to the public library's website. And then we also have a microsite, United for Literacy Info. And that is, we're trying, again, we're building it, but it's going to have all this information. So if you want to volunteer, if you want to donate, if you want to give books, we're starting our first book drive. So, you know, there's a lot of things that are going to start happening. We're just excited. We need everybody involved. People are really showing their interest in this. And you're absolutely right. This is about workforce development. This is poverty. This is crime. This is, yes. You know, if you are an educated individual and you know that you have worth and value in the community, you are going to go far. And that's what every person deserves.
Well, your passion is contagious. Yeah, thanks so much for sharing it with us today.
Absolutely.
We appreciate it.
Thanks for having us.